People with schizophrenia and bipolar disorder grow old, as do the rest of us. People with bipolar disorder experience severe highs and lows with respect to their mood, as well as changes in sleep, thinking patterns, and behavior, which mirror the mood swings. So when experiencing a highly elevated mood, for example, people with bipolar disorder often find they need little sleep, their thoughts are racing, and their behavior is erratic and impulsive. Psychotic disorders in later life have been less well recognized than instances of these disorders at younger ages. Consequently, older adults with such issues did not, and to a certain extent still may not, receive the support they need to maintain functionality and quality of life. Importantly, both current and past diagnostic criteria for psychosis and related disorders also remain problematic for older people. For example, the research on whether presentations of schizophrenia and bipolar disorder differ at different ages of first onset is still lacking. We need more research here in light of our growing older adult population. Both schizophrenia and bipolar disorder are relatively rare in later life. With respect to the gender ratio, both bipolar and schizophrenia in older adults is experienced by roughly 2 to 3 females per male affected. Older adults with schizophrenia represent a relatively large proportion of those with serious mental illness later in life. With respect to schizophrenia, 75% of older patients with schizophrenia will have experienced the onset of the disorder in early and midlife, and 25% in later life. Unfortunately, for both early and late onset bipolar disorder, many patients have recurring or residual symptoms. Older bipolar patients can appear similar to older patients with schizophrenia in terms of their levels of disability and functioning in the community. Over the course of several decades of life, treatment is likely to lead to better, although not necessarily normal, functioning for people with psychotic disorders. People with psychoses also learn from their experiences about how to manage the illness and avoid distressing relapses. Coping strategies also appear in some studies to evolve and improve with age, a hopeful area perhaps for future research. However, lack of treatment of those with schizophrenia in later life increases their risk of future nursing home placement. Given the fact that older persons with chronic mental illness may have made gains in adaptations to life with their illness as they've become older, group psychotherapy approaches with such patients may be particularly effective. Therapy approaches often target areas of everyday functioning, medication management, social skills, communication, organization and planning, transportation, and financial management. In working with older adults with chronic mental illness, drawing on their past experiences of how they've come to understand their illness and what they've learned from past treatment efforts, both positive and negative, is a rich resource for intervention. Thus, integrating their own learned coping strategies into therapeutic outreach can be most beneficial.